We're here at Polytech to show you our first field-installed direct air capture machine. What you see behind me is the direct air capture module, and it is retracted into the box. Now, it contains the sails that actually do the contacting with the air for the capture of carbon dioxide. So you can see the three panels behind me are made up of white leaves, and that's the material that we use to do the air capture of the carbon dioxide. It's an anionic exchange membrane, and it has a strong affinity for carbon dioxide when it's dry, and then when it's wet, it gives the CO2 back again. That's why we move it from inside the box, where we can make it wet, to outside in the air, where it can dry and pick up CO2. Once this cycle is complete, which takes about an hour or so, depending on wind speed, temperature, and humidity, I will retract the sail back into the box and we'll make it wet. Once we make it wet, that air is then extracted from the box, and it has a concentration of roughly 1% CO2, which is then moved over to this device on my left, which we call the carbonator. In that device, we contact that 1% CO2 enriched air with a sodium carbonate solution, where it is converted into a sodium bicarbonate solution. And that's how we store the carbon dioxide that we extract from this box in preparation of generating pure CO2. So now we've moved around to the backside of the carbonator. Just behind me on the left, there's a tall silver column there, and that's a thermoreactor column. We heat it up in that reactor column, and by heating that solution, we drive the CO2 off, and it comes off as a pure CO2 stream with a little bit of steam mixed in. That steam is condensed out right up here by this condensation trap, and the CO2 is accumulated in this black tank right here. And then by cascading it through a series of tanks and pumps, we can boost the pressure of that CO2 from 1 psi all the way up to 150 psi. And that's done with this small pump here, with this compressor back here, this medium pressure tank here, and this high pressure tank here. So once the CO2 reaches pressure in this high pressure tank, that's when we can deliver to the customer as a pressurized stream of pure CO2 that's been removed from the atmosphere through direct air capture.